Today we'll introduce the so-called Archimedes principle, a strikingly simple law of physics that's fundamental to fluid mechanics. Why, when we swim underwater, do we feel weightless? And why does one object sink in water while another, even something as heavy as a cruise liner, floats? Let's find out with the help of Archimedes of Syracuse. You might know him as the man rumored to have shouted "Eureka!" in the bathtub. Imagine some fluid in a beaker with a density of rho. Now, imagine dropping a block in the beaker. Its cross-sectional area is A and its height is H. The fluid puts pressure on the block on all six sides. Since the block is symmetrical, the pressure on the left balances the pressure on the right, and the pressure on the front balances the pressure on the back. But the pressure on the top of the block, P top, does not equal the pressure on the bottom, P bottom, because as you go deeper underwater, the pressure is greater. The net pressure on the block is the difference between P bottom and P top. Pressure at any point in a fluid is the product of three numbers: the fluid density, rho, the acceleration due to gravity, g, and the depth of the point in the fluid, h. So the net pressure on the block can be written as P equals rho gh bottom minus rho gh top, rewritten as rho g times h bottom minus h top. H bottom minus h top is simply the height of the object, so let's replace that with h. Pressure, P, is equal to force, F, per unit area, A. Let's substitute this in. Simplifying the equation one final time, we know that A times h is equivalent to the volume of the cube, V. So the net upward force F acting on the object can be calculated as the product of the fluid density, rho, gravitational acceleration, and volume of fluid displaced. We call this force the buoyant force. It's caused by the pressure on the bottom of an object being higher than the pressure at the top, and it's the reason why we feel weightless underwater. Now back to our friend Archimedes. His principle states that the upward buoyant force exerted on a body immersed in fluid equals the weight of the fluid displaced by the body. It holds true whether the body is fully immersed or floating on the surface. We can prove this principle quite simply. To find out the mass of displaced fluid, multiply the fluid's density, rho, by the volume of the displaced fluid, V. Since we know weight is mass times acceleration due to gravity, g, we can say that weight is equal to rho times v times g. Archimedes' principle tells us that the apparent loss of weight equals the weight of the displaced water. And so, we end up with the formula for buoyancy force. Our block sank when placed in fluid. Why? Objects sink when their density is greater than the density of the fluid. The fluid displaced by the object weighs less than the block. When calculating the buoyant force of a half-submerged object, be sure to measure only the volume submerged, not the volume of the entire object. As we asked at the beginning, how can a giant heavy ship float in the sea? Well, usually a ship has a hollow space at its bottom, mainly filled with air. So the ship's average density is less than that of the water. The ship can displace water enough to equal the ship's weight, and so the ship can float on the sea. We hope that the concept of buoyant force described by Archimedes' principle is now clear. Thanks for watching.